Shri Anurag Tripathi, IRPS, a man of Midas touch, with his ingenuity and visionary zeal, has reformed the system wherever he worked in the mighty Indian Railways as well as CBSE. We are fortunate to have him with us in the conference, and we are eagerly awaiting for his inputs, which can bring critical changes in the system of education. I respectfully invite you, sir, for the inaugural address.
Namaskar, good morning. Padma Vibhushan, Dr. E.Sreedharan ji, Dr. Vishwajit Saha, Director of Vocational and Training, CBSE, Secretary of RDPT, Shri Kutti Krishnan ji, Venu Principal, Dr. Manu Ranjini ji, Regional Officer, CBSE, Shri Tarun Kumar, Deputy Secretary, Center of Excellence, Kochi, Shri Pramod Kumar ji, my colleagues from CBSE, other dignitaries present here, and my dear delegates. I am very much delighted to see a gathering of CBSE teachers who have come from all over India and abroad to deliberate on education for sustainable development. This shows your spirit and how much you care for our future generations. The presence of Honorable Sreedharan ji will motivate us to walk the talk. Being a part of railway, I am inspired by the sustainable transport provided by Delhi Metro Rail Corporation under his leadership, which has become a reality under his visionary leadership. It is also visible in the functioning of Kochi Metro since its initial stages. This shows that instead of taking big steps in the first go, consistent small steps will lead us to a greater height. We should be motivated and convinced about the need for sustainability, and our collective actions will make it a reality. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sachchat Parbrahma, Tasmai Sri Guruve Nama. Prachin Vedo mein, hamare sahitya mein, hamare granthon mein, Guru ko Bhagwan ke barabar mana gaya hai. Ishwar woh sarvashrestha shakti hai, jo prakriti ka nirmaan karti hai. और ईश्वर तक पहुंचने का मार्ग गुरु हमारे टीचर्स आप मिलकर के दिखाते हैं. जब एजुकेशन की बात आती है, शिक्षा की बात आती है, व्हाट इज एजुकेशन, शिक्षा क्या है, बहुत प्राचीन बोध वाक्य है, सा विद्या या विमुक्तये, एजुकेशन लिबरेट्स. एजुकेशन हमें मुक्त करती है, एजुकेशन मुक्त करती है अंधकार से, एजुकेशन मुक्त करती है बुराइयों से, एजुकेशन मुक्त करती है हमें हिंसा से, गरीबी से, बेरोजगारी से, कुसंस्कारों से, असमानता से, तमाम सारी एविल्स से, जिससे हमारी सोसाइटी, पूरी वर्ल्ड सफर करती रहती है. एज ए टीचर, एज ए प्रिंसिपल, एज ए एजुकेशनिस्ट, हमारी और आपकी एक ग्रेटर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि हम एजुकेशन के इस उद्देश्य को, इस ऑब्जेक्ट को, इस प्राइमरी एम को पूरा करें और अपनी जिम्मेदारी निभाएं. आज की कॉन्फ्रेंस सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट पर एजुकेशन को ले आ रही है. मैं पहला प्रश्न पूछूंगा आप लोगों से, व्हाट इज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट? क्या हम कन्विंस हैं इस शब्द से? व्हाट इज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट? कोई भी उठ करके इसका उत्तर दे सकता है? एनीबडी, एनीवन? व्हाट इज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट? बहुत सुंदर। हम विकास ऐसा करें, हम डेवलपमेंट ऐसा करें जिससे हम और हमारी आने वाली पीढ़ी वो रह सके, टिक सके, आगे बढ़ सके। अगर इसका हिंदी वर्जन देखें तो इसका मतलब होता है टिकाऊ विकास, एक ऐसा विकास जो सस्टेनेबल हो, जो टिकाऊ हो, जो हमारे और हमारे आने वाले वर्षों तक रह सके। क्या आज का समाज, आज की एजुकेशन पॉलिसी, आज का एजुकेशन सिस्टम, आज के स्कूल्स, आज के टीचर्स, आज के प्रिंसिपल्स, इवन हमारे पेरेंट्स, ऐसी सोसाइटी का निर्माण कर रहे हैं जो सस्टेनेबल है? ऐसी पॉलिटिकल एटमॉस्फेयर का निर्माण क्या हमारे देश में हो रहा है जो सस्टेनेबल है? ऐसी इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट क्या हमारे कंट्री में हो रहा है, हमारे आसपास, जो सस्टेनेबल है? क्या हम अपने बच्चों को ऐसी शिक्षा दे रहे हैं, ऐसी एजुकेशन दे रहे हैं, ऐसी टीचिंग्स दे रहे हैं, ऐसी कल्चर दे रहे हैं जो सस्टेनेबल है? एज ए पेरेंट, टीचर तो हम उसके बाद आते हैं, एज ए पेरेंट क्या अपने घर के छोटे छोटे दो नन्हे मुन्ने बच्चों को ऐसे संस्कार, ऐसी कल्चर, ऐसी एजुकेशन, ऐसी टीचिंग्स दे रहे हैं जो सस्टेनेबल है, जो हमें फील कराती कि यस, हमने अपने, कम से कम अपने दो बच्चों को वो टीचिंग्स दी हैं, वो संस्कार दिए हैं, वो डेवलपमेंट किया है जो एजुकेशन का ऑब्जेक्ट है? मेरी रिक्वेस्ट है, एक बार इस प्रश्न को मुड़ करके अपने परिप्रेक्ष्य में, खुद के उसमें देखें। एज ए टीचर करोड़ों बच्चे आपसे बन करके निकलते हैं, एज ए पेरेंट हम अपने घर में भी वही काम करते हैं। अगर एज ए पेरेंट आप और हम अपने घर की बाउंड्री में इस सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट की एजुकेशन दे रहे हैं जिसमें वो बच्चा जब बड़ा हो हमारे माँ बाप का सम्मान करे, हमारे टीचर्स की रेस्पेक्ट करे, अपने सोसाइटी को साथ लेकर के आगे बढ़े, सस्टेनेबल हो, जो पॉलिटिकल एटमॉस्फियर है उसको ग्रूम करे, जो इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट है सिर्फ सेल्फ के लिए नहीं पूरे सोसाइटी के लिए डेवलप करने का प्रयास करे, और अगर इसका उत्तर आपके मन में हां है तो मैं बहुत खुश हूं इस जगह आकर के कि शायद एक कॉन्फ्रेंस उसको एक नई दिशा की ओर लेकर के जाएगी। माय डियर टीचर्स, प्रिंसिपल्स, इस फोरम के माध्यम से मेरी रिक्वेस्ट है, आप अपने स्टूडेंट्स में उस तरह की लर्निंग, उस तरह के स्किल, उस तरह के कल्चर, उस तरह के संस्कार इनकलकेट करने का प्रयास करें जो सस्टेनेबल हो। फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री, मैथ, बायो, साइंस, ह्यूमैनिटीज, हमारी क्लासेज में सिर्फ बच्चे रट रहे हैं, मार्क्स ले रहे हैं, कॉम्पिटिशंस क्रैक कर रहे हैं, या उससे उनकी लाइफ भी सुधर रही है, हमारी सोसाइटी भी सुधर रही है, और हमारे पूरे यूनिवर्स को, पूरे सोसाइटी को, पूरे कंट्री को उससे कुछ सस्टेनेबल या टिकाऊ योग्य विकास मिल पा रहा है? बच्चों को जहां जाना है वो जाएंगे, हमारी और आपकी जिम्मेदारी एज ए टीचर, एज ए पेरेंट, एज ए प्रिंसिपल, सबसे बड़ी ये है कि बच्चों के भीतर जो अच्छाइयां छुपी हुई हैं, जो सीड्स हैं, जो उनके भीतर ऑलरेडी चीजें विद्यमान हैं, उन्हें हम ग्रूम करें, उन्हें एनलाइटन करें, उन्हें रास्ता दिखाएं, और अगर हम ये कर ले जाते हैं तो शायद सबसे अच्छा सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट बच्चों का, एजुकेशन का और इस कॉन्फ्रेंस का यही होगा। पूरा ब्रह्मांड पंच भूतों से मिलकर के बना हुआ है, पृथ्वी, जल, अग्नि, वायु और आकाश, और ये पांचों एक सिनर्जी में हैं। ये पांचों की बॉन्डिंग आपस में बहुत जबरदस्त है। नेचर ने इन्हें बहुत बैलेंस बनाया है। हमारी आपकी बॉडी भी इन्हीं पंचभूतों से मिलकर बनी हुई है। हमारी जरूरत सिर्फ ये है कि जो ये पंच तत्व हैं, जो ये पंचभूत हैं, जिनसे मिल करके हमारे विचार, हमारा शरीर, हमारा मन, हमारा ब्रह्मांड बना हुआ है, उसको हम डिस्ट्रक्टिव ना होने दें, उसको हम नष्ट ना होने दें, उसको हम खत्म नहीं होने दें। एज ए टीचर, एज ए प्रिंसिपल, फिर मेरी रिक्वेस्ट यही रहेगी कि एक बार रिव्यू करें अपने आसपास की सोसाइटी को, अपने स्कूल्स को, अपने बिल्डिंग्स को, अपने बच्चों की ड्रेस को, अपने बच्चे के थॉट प्रोसेस को, बच्चों के संस्कार को, एजुकेशन पॉलिसी, इवन एग्जामिनेशन प्रोसेस, उनको रिव्यू करने के तरीके को कि क्या ये जो नेचर ने बॉन्डिंग पंच तत्वों की है, ये कहीं बिखर तो नहीं रहा है, और ट्राई करें कि उसकी बॉन्डिंग उन बच्चों में कंप्लीट रूप में आए। सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट वो होगा जब माइंड, बॉडी एंड सोल, इन तीनों को अपने बच्चों में आप इनकलकेट कर पाएंगे, एक सिनर्जी में ला पाएंगे। सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज आज की सोसाइटी के यही है कि पढ़ने लिखने के बाद भी बच्चे अपने को, अपनी सोसाइटी को, अपनी फैमिली को, अपने पेरेंट्स को, अपने पॉलिटिकल एटमॉस्फियर को भी आगे लेकर के नहीं चल पाते। एक बार फिर इस शानदार कॉन्फ्रेंस के अवसर पर, एक बहुत ही नोबेल कॉन्फ्रेंस के अवसर पर, मेरा निवेदन इस पूरी फोरम से अंतिम सिर्फ यह है कि जो है उससे बेहतर चाहिए, पूरी दुनिया साफ करने के लिए एक मेहतर चाहिए, और आपको और हमें उस मेहतर की भूमिका निभानी होगी, तभी एक्चुअली इस सोसाइटी का असली सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट होगा। थैंक यू, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Thank you, sir, for motivating us with your marvelous oration. Let us remember that we should take consistent steps to reach greater heights. We should bond well with each other for sustainable development. Padma Vibhushan, Dr. E.Sreedharan, the legendary engineer of the contemporary times, widely acclaimed as India's Metro Man, has been the master brain behind Delhi Metro and Konkan Railways. Sir has made an indelible imprint in the minds of Kochiites by bringing Kochi Metro to a reality. The nation has decorated him with prestigious Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, and Padma Vibhushan awards. A noble man with a character of great heights, a leader of multifarious notions, sir, you are an inspiration to all of us. Indeed, it's a proud moment to have you with us, sir, in the conference. With extreme pride and honor, may I invite you, sir, to enlighten us with your words of wisdom.
Shri Anurag Tripathi, Secretary, CBSE, Dr. Biswaj Saha, Director, respected Kuttikrishnan, Secretary, Rashtradharma Parishad, Shri Tarun Kumar, Shri Pramod Kumar, and Dr. Manorinjini, venue principal, respected delegates to this meet, ladies and gentlemen, this is the first time I am standing before such a huge, large gathering of principals and teachers. That makes me a little nervous. It gives me a sense of awe, appreciation, and respect. And I wonder, what is that a civil engineer or a technocrat like me can bring to you? First of all, I want to compliment CBSE for organizing this conference. It's a brilliant idea. There are more than 20,000 schools in the country with CBS syllabus. I personally consider this as the most significant bond for integration in the country itself. So many schools having the same syllabus. That itself is a great achievement. And today, very correctly, the theme selected for discussion is education for sustainable development. Mr. Anurag Tripathi posed a question to you. What is sustainable development? Just before coming to this conference, I took up the Oxford Dictionary to find out, because I am still learning, to find out what exactly is sustainable development. It gives very clearly, briefly, what it is. It says, development not leading to depletion of natural resources or degradation of the environment. That is sustainable development. It is very easily explained, but very difficult to practice. Now, what are the challenges for the sustainable development for the whole world as well as for us as well, for the country as well? You know, the whole world is divided into two halves. Very developed and rich countries and very poor and undeveloped countries. The gap is too wide. The powerful countries use their power to garner maximum from the nature, their resources. And the poor countries are left to struggle. This is one challenge that has got to be faced. In our own country, even after 70 years of independence, where are we today? Even now, 40% of our population is below poverty line. And it's very shameful that in a country like ours, 1% of the population control almost 68% of the nation's wealth. That means the sort of inequality that is pervading today. We have a population of almost 130 crores today. And our population is increasing almost by one Australia population every year. And imagine our population is getting added by one Australia population every year. With the result, the per capita share of our natural resources in our country is so little. because the population is so huge. In fact, the per capita share of our population is almost 1 by 500 of Australia's. That means Australia has nearly 500 times the per capita share of natural resources. We don't have it. Now, with this context and background, what is that all of you assembled here can contribute? I am personally convinced that sustainable development is possible only through education. This is the real medium to bring in sustainable development in this country. Mr. Anurag Tripathi had very eloquently brought out to you the various areas where teachers and principals can contribute. He even went to the extent of saying that Guru is Devatatma. That is what he is really mentioned. Yours is a very noble profession of which you should be really proud of. It's a very noble profession. In fact, I would say the future and destiny of our country really is with you, the educational institutions. If you are able to train up our young generation to grow with values and principles, ethics, respecting the nature, that itself is a great contribution that we can make. Apart from my role as an engineer in charge of various infrastructure projects, I also these days am actively involved in spreading values in whatever platforms I get, for the simple reason that I am the national president of an organization called Foundation for Restoration of National Values, FRNV. FRNV is a non-religious, non-profit, non-communal type of an organization, mainly devoted to instill values so that persons individually and collectively have an inner persuasion to be truthful, to be tolerant, to be useful to society. That is what is required. I had an opportunity to address about 100 principals on first of this month, the Council of Principals, an assembly of about more than 100 principals at Kutikanam, very near to Munnar. There I was also talking about the same, very same subject. How to mold our children, how to instill good values in them, how to make them really useful citizens of this country. I am firmly of the view that education institutions are places where we prepare our future generation. And that responsibility is with you. Incidentally, my only daughter, is also a principal of a CBSE school. I wonder why she did not turn up for this conference. She is the principal of Dean's Academy in Bangalore. And from a distance, I really admire the way she runs the school, to tell you very frankly. The type of discipline that is in the school, the type of orderliness, the emphasis on cleanliness, good behavior, and the good rapport with the parents. You see, you can't mold the children all by yourself. You need the assistance, cooperation of the parents as well. That is where the real success lies. And I found her exceptionally competent in doing that. Ours is a poor country. We have the unfortunate situation in which, according to the UN World Happiness Index, our country is 137 out of 158 countries, so poor, which is UN World Happiness Index, so poor. Finland is number one. Even Pakistan is 78. Just imagine how backward we are in this particular respect. My respected teachers and principals, this can be changed only by education institutions. I don't think Mr. Narendra Modi or his team of cabinet colleagues can change the country, because the country's population is growing so fast. Any type of economic development that is taking place is not able to match with the increase in number of population. That is why, even after 70 years, we have more than 40% of population below poverty line. It is only the educational institutions can change, according to me. Unfortunately, I don't think we have a very good educational system. I'm not going into the merits of the syllabi that is prescribed in various institutions, but I'm aware of one particular thing. The success of our education depends upon the caliber of our teachers, the competence of our teachers, their attitude, and the way they handle the students. That is where emphasis is required. Conference of this type is really very useful in this respect. And I am told in this conference, number of papers have been invited, they have been shortlisted, and many of the problems being faced in the CBSE, many of the challenges involved in having an education for sustainable development, all this will be discussed. I am sure these discussions will be very constructive, very useful, and all of you will go back highly enriched by the knowledge that you have got. If you are able to instill simple values in the children, like what Mr. Anurag was mentioning, simple values, simple, ordinary way the child should be shaped, that itself will make a whole difference in the whole country. As I mentioned, Mr. Narendra Modi can't do this by a magic wand. It's only the schools can do. And that is what you have the responsibility. This can be done not only by instructions, by demonstrations, by practical demonstration of how it is to be done. Our Prime Minister has started the Swachh Bharat. He wants the whole country to be clean. If you see around what is happening, we should feel really ashamed. Swachh Bharat is not merely constructing toilets. It is making the whole environment so clean. Around our houses, around the classrooms, in the campuses, not only physical cleanliness, but also mental illumination and cleanliness. That is also equally important. And when I came into this campus, I was so happy to see how clean and orderly this place is. The credit should go to Mr. Kutikishan and Dr. Manoranjini. Why can't we do it everywhere? There are very many areas I think teachers have to concentrate. Ms. Anurag Tripathi had mentioned a few. I have noted a few things which I would like to place before you. One is Swachh Bharat by demonstration. Tell him that the definition of cleanliness, what is definition of cleanliness? Matter out of place is dirt. That is a cleanliness. Anything out of place is dirt. That has got to be taught to children. Then the need for afforestation, how it can be done to augment the natural resources. Water preservation, simple things. Teach him that if he's brushing his teeth, don't keep the tap on all the time. Water should not be wasted. The value of water, that has got to be taught to children. Rainwater harvesting, organic farming, energy saving, electricity, unnecessary electricity not to be wasted, maximize solar power, then solid waste management, how it is to be done, simple things. Then elimination of mosquito menace. These two things we have taken up, FRN we have taken up as a big agenda item, as one of our major activity in Kochi city, mosquito menace. I'm not going to talk to you about sustainable transport system. Of course, Kochi Metro is a glaring example of a sustainable transport system. In short, ladies and gentlemen, we have to instill good values in the children. Do you know in Japan, in class one, the children are taught only good values, ethics, how to behave with elders, how to respect teachers. They are not taught any subject at all, only these things. And see how that nation has come up. Why can't we do the same thing here? It all depends upon you. Such a large number of teachers and principals are assembled here. You can certainly take back this message. Transform your school at least as a model school in this respect. Children should have absolutely good values. And most important, they should learn to respect their teachers, which is not happening today. They should know that the elders have to be respected. They should have consideration for the neighbor, for the boy, for the student sitting next to him. This sort of thing has got to be taught. Unless this is done, this nation cannot progress. I am very happy to have this unique opportunity to be with you this morning. And I'm extremely grateful to the CBSE officers, and particularly Pramod Kumar, who has been constantly chasing me, and Dr. Manoranjini. She was the first person to contact me. I was a little hesitant when she contacted me first. I told her I will think over it. Then I thought, what a good opportunity I will have if I come over here to meet such a large section of teachers and principals to convey the message that I have to improve the value education that is so necessary for the country. I'm extremely grateful to them for giving this opportunity. Let me conclude by stating, Loka Samasta Sugino Bhavandu. Thank you very much.